Welcome back from that short break. And of course, you're still watching Abin Today right here on Abin Television. In case you just missed the first 30 minutes of the show, it's very simple. Just head over to our Facebook page, that is Abin Television. And for Twitter, it is at Abin TV Uganda. Get to catch up with what we have been talking about. And in case you want to give us some feedback regarding any interesting news that you could be having, use the hashtag Abin Today over on Twitter and Facebook. Right about now, we're going to be talking about internship in different organizations and experiences that have been acquired by different interns from different institutions of higher learning. Now, on my right, I do have a gentleman called Peter Nanguru. Good morning to you, Peter.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm okay.
Interesting. Then on my left, I have a lady called Cynthia Alinda. How are you?
I'm good.
How's your morning?
It's good.
I'm going to give you guys 1 minute of film to talk about yourselves before you even get internship. Is this your first time appearing on TV?
Not
really. It's not? Oh, yeah. You've been on TV before?
Yeah.
Interesting. Cynthia?
My first time.
Okay, let's begin with the lady right here. About you, tell the viewers about you.
I'm Cynthia Arinda. I'm a student at Ndeja University in my third year.
Okay.
And I'm doing journalism and mass communication.
All right. That's it. That's what you feel like the viewers should know.
Yes.
All right, Peter, how about you?
Okay, I'm Peter Nangulu from YMCA. And doing computer science.
Okay. Final year as well?
Yeah.
Interesting. Now let us zero it down to the experience that you have achieved so far. First and foremost, what made you, you know, think about doing internship down here at Vision Group? Was it something that was a self-decision or someone pushed you into it?
Actually, I knew that this is the best thing. I mean, this is the best organization I should come to, because the way you see, we have there like 5-4 radio, 3 TVs, and newspapers and magazines, and I saw that this is the best organization I should do my internship from.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cynthia, how about you? What made you feel like, you know, New Vision or Vision Group should be the place for you to be for internship?
I think I had testimonies. People who have been here, they've had more of the practicals, and other organizations, it's just they sit around and they do nothing, but here there are more practicals, and yeah, it's evident with the practicals, hands-on.
As a student of journalism and communication, what is your main goal? Where do you see yourself in about, you know, the next 1 hour, 2 hours? Because if you're in third year, that means literally this is your final year. Oh, I think next year should be your final for your last semester. Where do you see yourself now that you're getting this training, you're getting these hands-on skills? Where do you project yourself?
I think I love camera, so I see myself having my own
production house.
Yes, production house, and I love taking pictures. So, yeah, maybe a photography company, something like that.
So have you, you know, showed these people down here at Vision Group your photography skills yet?
Yeah, I have.
All right. Yeah. Peter, how about you? Where do you project yourself in the next 1 year, 2 years from now? Because now you're getting the hands-on experience. You are, you know, suited up for the working environment.
Okay. To me, I like much networking. I would like to be
looking through the camera. People need to see the person that is talking to them.
Okay. I like networking so very much, and I've put much emphasis on knowing more when I'm here. We've tried to do many things which has helped me in my professional networking. We terminated cables, configured phones. We've visited many servers here. We've done a lot, and I know by the time I leave this place, I'll be the best.
You are in the IT department, right?
Yes.
How has it been for you in terms of experience so far?
Okay.
You've been around for a month now, right?
Yeah,
I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
How has the experience been for you?
Okay, it's been the best because I've gotten new ideas. Right now, I can do many things which I didn't know, because at campus, we do too much theory. By the time you leave campus, when you know nothing. But only in this just 1 month I've been here, I've gotten very many ideas of what I didn't know that I can do. Right now, I can configure phones. those landlines. Yeah.
I hope you don't use that skill to, you know, steal into people's homes and have this food.
No. So I can do many things.
Okay.
Terminating cables, you know.
So what you're trying to say is down at your school, you did not have this kind of practical skill attached to the theory bit that they taught you in class?
It's not much.
Okay.
It's not much. We do much theory.
Theory compared to practical.
Yeah.
All right. Cynthia, your experience so far, you have been one of the interns that is usually working together with Farouk on the camera bit, and I'm not so sure about your field work because I've not been with you personally. But how has the experience been for you so far?
It is fun. And it's okay. I have been treated well. I have not had any hardship so far compared to what others are saying. So it is okay. I'm really okay.
Journalism is not one of the easiest, you know, kind of professions to do. There definitely must be challenges. If I remember way back when I was an intern, I was also, you know, succumbed to some technical challenges. What have been some of, you know, the best hardships that you have had to deal with? And how did you even get through them?
I don't have as many as they could be, but I think when you're doing a live show, you have to be really fast, and I think I am not that fast. And the pressure mounts, and so you make a mistake, and maybe someone screams at you, and you feel bad. So yeah, that is it, basically. I've not been to the field, but people in the field are saying it's really hard to be in field. So my hardships now, they are not that much.
All right, interesting. Peter, any hardships are coming in from your side? You seem to be having interesting ones. I hope you have not been sexually harassed, have you?
No.
Okay, interesting. Now let's move on.
Okay.
What have been some of your hardships?
Like, because this is my first experience when I'm doing things practically, so I found some difficulties in doing such things. And another which I can tell you that maybe when it comes to servicing things like that, servicing computers.
Is there someone crushing on you that is giving you hard time to work? Because you look like you're giving me that smile of, man, is this catchy? You talk to me, what's going on?
No, not really. Yeah. Actually, I thought that when I come here that I'll find people being so proud and so kind of, but it is not like that. People here are too kind, and they love everyone they meet.
Okay. I want us to rate, you know, internship program as one of the things that we need to do before we leave the higher levels of learning, that is the universities. If you had to rate this kind of program out of 10, how many marks would you give it? And do you actually think it is very valid for any student actually undergo through internship? Let me begin with you, Cynthia.
Yeah, on a scale of 10, it's 10. Because personally, it's only theoretical at school, at campus. So when you come here, it's actually the practical part of it. So if I'm to stay at school and I'm doing nothing, there's nothing like internship. Now, I wouldn't have gotten this practical bit of it if I had not done internship. So yeah, internship is very relevant.
Okay. Peter, how about you? If we're to cross over to your side, in writing, let's begin with the writing.
Okay.
Of the program itself.
Actually, to me, internship is the best. And it's what each and everyone should do. Because, as I told you that, that when you are here, when you are doing internship, we do things practically, and we learn more compared to what we learn when we are at campus. You find you waste too much time at campus, years and years, and you learn nothing in the field. But here, during internship, you learn practical things, you do practical things, which is the best thing we should do.
So do you think, are you trying to say that there's actually, you know, a problem somewhere that needs to be solved regarding the co-curricular services that we get from school in terms of studies, you know, the syllabus that we follow? Because from what you're saying, you literally do not have any chance of having any practical skills from your institution of learning.
Yeah, actually, that's the very thing I'm telling you that at campus they should do some changes, and we do much of practical, because it is what we do in the field, not theoretical part of it. Yeah.
Cynthia, from Deji University, theoretical lessons vis-a-vis practical lessons, which one do you think needs to be boosted a little bit more?
The practical lessons should be boosted more.
So you guys do not have any theoretical kind of practices done at the university in regards to journalism and communication?
I don't remember having any, really.
Wow, okay. Yeah. That's very sad. But now, if you're given an opportunity right here at Vision Group to, you know, stay and get fully employed, what are some of the things that you think you would add to the company? Who wants to go first? Cynthia? Ladies first. If they walked in right here, if you know, our CEO walked in right here like he usually likes to do and tells you, you know what, I've given you a job, what do you think you would add to the company? From the training you've had for 1 month, the ins and outs, what do you think you'd be able to add to the company right now? Is it your efficiency? Is it your skill? What is that?
My skill?
It's still growing.
Yes, it's still growing.
Okay.
But I think I would see someone who is so devoted. I'd pledge my devotion and my time and my seriousness.
Oh, okay. All right. How about you, Peter? Well, what is that one thing you would add onto the table of the IT department?
Okay. I'm someone who is determined and I love what I do. Once I'm given a chance, I do it with all my heart to please someone who gave me the chance.
Okay.
So once I'm given a chance here, I will do my best.
They cannot go wrong.
Yeah.
When you were coming into such a big company, you definitely had expectations, right? You had some things you were looking forward to. Were those expectations met? Do you feel like you're on your way to achieve those expectations, Peter?
Yeah. Because.
What were even some of these expectations before we get into if you have achieved them or not? What expectations did you have when you were getting into Vision Group?
Actually, I wanted to get more experience and knowing more in practical.
Okay. All right.
And by the time I leave this place, I believe that everything, all the expectations I had, will be.
You will have achieved them.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's true.
Cynthia, what were your expectations you had before joining New Vision?
I thought, I knew I would get the experience, and I am antisocial, so I came here with a goal of leaving this place as a social person.
Okay.
Yeah, and I think I've made a lot of friends, the ones I didn't expect.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
Okay. Let's talk about the experience from other friends of yours. You know, I believe you have classmates, you have people you go to the same, lectures with, as same as you. Cynthia, when you are sharing, you know, those kind of experiences, what kind of, warnings do you get from them regarding their experience in their internship places?
I think they're bored. They do nothing. They're complaining because they ask me, how is the intern? And I'm like, it's fun. I'm always doing this. I'm always doing that. And they're like, no. We are seated all day, there's nothing we do, so I think they are bored. Really.
Are those the same students that are doing journalism and communication?
Yes, journalism and mass communication.
Wow, that's very sad. Peter, how about you? Well, what kind of feedback do you always get from your fellow interns?
Actually, I've tried to contact many, but what they're telling me is it's not interesting. There's one I called recently, was telling me, here we are doing just entering data, things like that. And when you compare with the way we do here, it is very, very different.
Okay.
Because here we've visited many places, I've visited servers, server rooms, control rooms, factories, stores, so many places. I mean, I know that by the time I leave this place, by the way, my employer will be so pleased to
employ you.
To employ me.
Well, what is the biggest goal you have in life as you know, a computer science student?
Okay, as I told you that I want to become a network administrator. I love much networking than anything else.
So every day you're waking up, coming to work, you believe that you can achieve that goal?
Yeah, yeah.
What are some of the main highlights that you have so far during your internship program? Some of you know, those moments you have shared lightly and you feel like, yeah, this is an interesting one for me to remember.
Okay. I remember we did we've terminated cables, we've configured phones, we've learned how to use virtual machine player. All those things. I've learned to repair switches, computers. Those are the things which I've been yearning for since I started this course of computer science.
So usually they give them to you in the theory bit, but now you have hands-on.
Yeah, and it's what I wanted all along.
Okay. Cynthia, how about you? What are some of those memories or highlights that you're going to hold dear for, even when you leave this place?
I think working with a lot of people and having to deal with a lot of people with different characters, and it has, personally, it is a fun experience, and I believe it's going to be fun for the 3 months I'm going to be here.
Yeah. Being an intern is not something that comes off with an ease. You have a lot of new faces you're seeing every day. You have a lot of new attitudes that you need to deal with every day. You have people who have different backgrounds, someone coming to work with their own personal problems, and they inject onto you as an intern. What is the main goal that keeps you going? What is your driving purpose as Cynthia in order to achieve, you know, the dream that you have of building your own production house?
I think I know what I want, and I know what I came for, and I think I have learned to embrace diversity. They are very, like you said, someone has a work problem, maybe it's just a one thing, so you have to just understand them, and maybe the next day they come in, they're better, so I don't judge people normally.
Okay. Yeah. Last but not least, would you recommend someone to actually have their internship done at Vision Group?
Yeah.
You would? Yeah. All right. Cynthia, how about you?
100%.
All right. Now, there you have it. We have been talking to, you know, some interns are coming in from different departments. You are with the camera department?
Yes.
Camera department, and then of course we do have the information technology department, that is of course our IT, that in charge over the internet and different connectabilities like he was mentioning. But what we're going to do right about now, we're going for a very short break. When we do get back, I have some interesting news coming in from the Sorority Anglican Diocese. What is happening recently? They have a new bishop. What has he said regarding to the new people that are getting married? All that information will be coming in right after this break.